Hello, welcome to NewsClick. As you all know, on November 25th, the Rajya Sabha has passed Transgender Persons Protection of Rights Bill 2019 amid widespread protests from the community across the country. Though the opposition parties has urged the parliament to send the bill for a final scrutiny, it was not done and the bill was passed. Earlier, on August 5, the Lok Sabha had passed the bill without having much discussions. So today we have with us Ray, a transgender activist and a student, and Shun Banerjee, a lawyer and a transgender activist, to talk about the ongoing protest and how inclusive the recommendations of the Transgender Bill 2019 are. There is a particular definition about transgender. So how happy are you about the definition of transgender in the particular bill?
I would say that we are not happy with the definition, because the definition even now conflates intersex persons with transgender persons. We often have this stereotype of transgender persons usually being people, you know, who are different at birth, but that's not the case. That's usually intersex persons, may or may not at birth, have different characteristics which we may not be able to classify within clearly within male or female. What this bill is doing is putting intersex persons under the definition of transgender persons. They may identify as man or woman or transgender person, but directly putting them under the definition of transgender person is taking away their right to self-identify as man or woman. In this country, when there is so little information and understanding of even transgender persons and intersex persons, taking this right away is going to put more amount of stigmatization and ostracization for even intersex persons.
So how this definition is contradicting with the NALSA judgment?
So when we talk about the definition of transgender, we should talk about the definition included in the Tiruchi Siva bill. So the Tiruchi Siva bill is a private member bill which was introduced in the Rajya Sabha, and it was introduced in 2014. So around 15, right? Yeah. So I will read out the definition that that is mentioned in that particular bill. It says that a transgender person means a person whose gender does not match with the gender assigned to that person at birth, and includes trans men and trans women. So this part is there in this particular bill also in 2019. What they did not include is that there is a, in this Tiruchi Siva bill, they also included whether or not they have undergone sex reassignment surgery or hormone therapy or laser therapy, etc. So they have excluded this part where they say that it is not necessary or mandatory for you to go through a sex reassignment surgery or a hormone therapy or a laser therapy to be associated under this particular definition of transgender bill, transgender. So this is the main difference in the bill, in the Tiruchi Siva bill and the current bill. So it is actually taking away or snatching away the right of self-identification, because they are making it necessary and mandatory for us to be biologically, to biologically prove our gender, you know, and which is also against the NALSA judgment, which says that it makes it illegal for us to be identified as a male or female through a biological test. They say the only test that is allowed or that is legal is a psychological test, and any kind of biological test being asked from a transgender person is illegal. So this definition is contradicting the NALSA judgment directly.
Transgender Bill 2019 talks about the involvement of district magistrate in the process to get the identity certificate. So tell us the processes of this getting identity certificate, and is it a regressive process, or how it is affecting the dignity of a person?
The only way that we can change that particular identity of a transgender to male or female is only after the sex reassignment surgery. Mm-hmm. For that, there is another national agency of transgender, National Council of Transgender Person. There's a new authority that they will be making under this particular act. So this is regressive, because this is asking a person to prove their identity of male or a female through a biological test, because they are making it necessary for us to go through a SRS. Only then we can go and change our gender from transgender to male or female.
Even now my documents state that I am a male or a man. And I claim or I self-identify as a woman. So if I have to change the legal documents under this bill, if the bill passes and becomes an act, what will happen is I'll have to go to the district magistrate. Right now, without any surgery, I will be given certificate only as a transgender person. Once I go through the surgery, then the chief medical officer will have to give me a certificate. Then I'll have to reapply to the district magistrate. And the bill mentions the word satisfied. That is purely giving discretion in the hands of the district magistrate. This entire bill is about giving power to everyone else. If you see the bill, it's giving power to the district magistrate. It's giving power to the chief medical officer. It's giving power to the court. All these people over us. But not to the very transgender persons whose rights this bill claims to protect.
So while talking about the surgery, normally how expensive are these surgeries? And is our country well equipped to perform such surgeries in current scenario?
First of all, our country is not equipped. Even if there are surgeries being performed, even the best of the doctors are not extremely experienced, the levels which we see in the international levels. Because if, this surgery and as such transgender persons' identities have been very stigmatized. So, and medical community has pathologized us like anything. They made us into a disease, then shifted to disorder. Now they've understood that it is not. So, even under the surgery, it is expensive, first. Second, there is no strong medical negligence law. Even this bill does not have any kind of penalty for transgender persons who are going through surgery and who are facing some wrong consequences of going through the surgery. Mm-hmm. Like there are people who have died on the operation table, people who have had lifelong health consequences because of the surgery. The surgeon can only do so much. Many times, we might end up going to some other doctor also. The very fact that doctors themselves do not even want to touch us. Many doctors who do not want to even, you know, talk to us without stereotyping us, is the fact that, you know, access to medical care is very, very difficult. And this bill does not even mention free access. It only says access.
The bill doesn't talk about the free access.
It doesn't mention anywhere that we'll get free access to gender affirming procedures. Okay. And currently now in India, all this is classified under cosmetic surgery. It is not classified under a vital or important surgery. So we don't get insurance coverage also.
In the particular bill, it doesn't talk about the expenses or whether the government is going to bear the expenses or not, right?
See, even under this bill, earlier versions of the bill said 20 crores in its financial memorandum.
Yeah.
Then it said 4 crores.
Yeah.
Now it's only 1 crore.
Yeah.
I mean, make it 0 crores if you don't want to give us money, if you don't want to give money to implement the objectives of a certain act or legislation, then why set out a piecemeal amount of money?
I would like to add one example of Kerala over here, because in Kerala, the state government has introduced a special transgender policy. So in that policy, they ensured reservation in certain colleges and for higher education. And in health system, I mean in the healthcare system, in all medical colleges, there is a separate team to deal with the issues of this community. And it's free of cost, absolutely. So in that way, it's helping the community to treat their issues. I mean, if the person wants to go for a sex reassignment surgery, then the government will bear the cost also.
For this, actually, I think we also need to understand that the kind of discrimination that we go, people generally ask, why do you need reservation? Why do you think education, you need reservation in education or employment? So I'm not saying that. We are not saying that. It's the NALSA judgment that said that. And we were fighting for our personhood and our rights because this discrimination starts back from the colonial period under the Criminal Tribes Act, where a lot of communities, including the Banjara communities, were also banned, and the people in the transgender communities were also banned to do certain works, to do certain occupations. They were banned. And this affected the mindset of the people so much that we can still see the signs of the mindset even after the Criminal Tribe Act was repealed. And this is pushing the, you know, there is a line through which there's a starting line. And when we say we need reservation, because everybody is not starting from that particular starting line. Mm-hmm. We are actually behind, and the reservation will only bridge the gap. And that bridging of gap is the reason why we ask for reservation. It's not something that because we are marginalized. No, there is a lot of discrimination, and there has been a lot of stigma around this particular issue. Yeah.
In the bill, there is one clause for National Council for Transgender Persons, but how inclusive is this particular council? Were you demanding for a national commission instead of national council?
If you remember, there was a Kochi metro, whole thing that happened where the metro hired transgender persons. I mean, there is a lot of criticism of that too, of how it went by, because reality of society, right?
Yeah, yeah.
But the very fact that there was a police commissioner of Kochi city who came in and who made very transphobic comments saying that we will remove all these people, all these nuisance from the city.
Mm-hmm.
Such people are the ones who have to be held accountable by this council,
mm-hmm.
who have to be sensitized.
Mm-hmm.
The government should be held accountable for their implementation of the schemes. National Council is going, National Commission, on the lines of commissions for minorities that have been existing in this country and on the lines of National Commission for Women, is what we have been demanding. This council has a majority of cisgender persons,
mm-hmm.
deciding for transgender persons.
Mm-hmm.
Five transgender persons, how are you deciding, how are you going to pick up five transgender persons? So all this debate, the Rajya Sabha unfortunately did not go into. This National Council is toothless, powerless to do anything. For everything, the Social Justice Minister has only one response. Reservation, rules. National Council problem, rules. Everything, rules. Then why are you making a legislation? Make a policy and go about it. Bringing a legislation in Parliament is to, is for all the representatives, people's representatives, to sit down and deliberate and see what is the best path, and remind ourselves that this is a democracy where executive has to be held accountable by the legislature, which unfortunately I don't understand why the executive and the social justice minister does not want to. Everything in the rules, then I don't understand. Don't make an act for us.
As per the bill, the transgender person cannot protect another transgender person if the person is facing some violence. And subsequently, the bill talks about rehabilitation centers. So, isn't it devaluing the kinship of the community which is prevailing right now?
Not all the families of transgender people, they are being supported by the families. And it will be great if the government is actually coming up with a shelter so that, we have all the facilities.
Mm-hmm.
But when you say rehabilitation, you treat that person as someone who has some disorder or is suffering through
saving.
Some illness. Yeah.
Who needs saving?
Who needs saving? We don't need saving. If there are some facilities that you will provide us, please provide it to us under the name of shelter, not rehabilitation. If you don't consider transgender people as something in the name of humanity, if you say someone, tell someone, don't help this person, it's the same as don't help this person after they meet with an accident on the road. And even if they are bleeding, you can have a police case. So don't help that person. So this will be the mindset that people will carry.
So for example, if I am under 18 and I have a problem with my family, the court will decide where I am going to stay. That's what I said. It ties back to the previous answer I gave, that the court, the chief medical officer, the district magistrate, all these three people are going to decide how our bodies are going to look like, where our bodies are going to stay, and where our bodies are going to move.
Mm-hmm.
So that is not right, no? If we can make an argument that people may not have any kind of friends, nobody wants to help, put a mandate on the states and the union government to open up shelter homes everywhere. Don't put the mandate on transgender persons to go into rehabilitation centers. We have Hijra groups, Skinner groups, we have Joktas, Jogappas, Arvanis. There are so many traditional socio-cultural communities in India to whom many of us, especially trans women, end up. And that is not being recognized under this bill. This bill says forced and bonded labor means they'll be criminalized. This bill does not no longer mention begging. But we all know that if they can't touch the nose by this way, they'll touch the nose the other way. And they will say that forced and bonded labor in implementation will mean police will arrest the gurus and elders of the community. That is what is going to happen. Even under the anti-trafficking bill, administration of hormones is being criminalized. Okay. A lot of us transgender persons are not given medical care, as I already said. Mm-hmm. So a fellow transgender person giving hormones to one more transgender person is criminalized. So I don't know what the government is up to.
Also, in the obtaining identity certificate, a minor person, that parents of that minor person has to apply for the certificate. So, I mean, in a way, it's forcing the community to go back to the blood relations.
If we want to change our name, say, for example, my name is Ray. I want to change it to Kanmani. I can't change my second name. I can only change my first name. If I have a problem with my family, the court will decide and put me in a rehabilitation center with no time limit. So if I'm gone there, I'm gone forever. Mm. It's like they are trying to ghettoize us. They are trying to put us back into our natal families, forgetting that natal families are one of the first people who perpetrate violence on us, often. Mm. And that we have other structures which may not conform in your cis-heteronormative understanding of families. Of natal families. They don't want that, you know, they don't want us to go beyond binary. They don't want us to go beyond family. And they don't certainly want us to decide our futures.
Okay.
And have rights over body.
Right. What government in other countries, like some of the countries that I know, comparatively, they provide counseling for the parents,
yeah.
You know, which is... So that even the parents can identify gender dysphoria in their kids from the very start, because that will be helpful for the kids. Psychological issues will be less. The trauma will be less, because there is a lot of, under gender dysphoria, the confidence of a kid gets affected a lot. And if the parents are given counseling, they will have awareness around this issue and they will not look at it as a disorder or as a disease in their children, you know.
And I don't understand how does the bill expect transgender children on the streets to access services of the court?
Exactly.
I mean, I am a law student and I know for a fact that the court is extremely inaccessible to even very educated law students and lawyers. How are children under 18 going to access the court? And is the court going to take in their consent, their inputs, as to where they want to stay? There is nothing under this bill which provides for the court to take in our inputs, where we want to stay. The bill simply says, if you have problem with the family, the court will put you in a rehabilitation center. That is basically like ghettoizing us. Aap family mein nahi reh sakte, aap parivar mein nahi reh sakte, to aap yahan jaake raho.
The funny part is the court is not approachable even after you are more than 18.
Yeah.
You know?
Have you gotten any chance to convey your concerns and demands over this particular issue?
See, I don't understand. I don't understand what consultation means, because if they are going to consult us on a bill which affects us, they should be taking in our inputs. There was a whole parliamentary standing committee with MPs from both Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha, and there were transgender persons from across the country who deposed before that committee. Mm-hmm. It brought out a huge amount of recommendations based on an early version of this bill. But none of those recommendations, except improving the definition, made it to this bill. Even the begging clause was removed only after, like, we have been protesting for 2-3 years. Social Justice Minister by now knows all our inputs, what our demands. But somehow everything for him is in the rules, including the fact that, you know, for sexual abuse and rape, he'll put everything in the rules, and that sexual abuse is not the same as rape. I don't I mean, we have tried and made them understand MPs after MPs. I mean, how opposition MPs have spoken. Mm-hmm. There were more than 20 opposition MPs who spoke. And many, many MPs spoke against the bill. Mm-hmm. But not even one amendment was taken by the government. Yeah. So this shows very clearly that they know what are the demands. It's just that they don't want to take in the amendments.
So are you people planning for further protest in coming days?
What is the other option? Give us another option, we'll take that. There is no other option, you know, because if we will not protest, there is no, this is the only right we have right now.
There is already protests going on.
There is already protests going on.
There were protests nationwide. In Bangalore, Hyderabad, there is protests in Mumbai, Pune, Chennai. There have been press conferences which have been held in Delhi and multiple other cities. The issue is that these kind of protests is not like just after this bill has been passed now. Mm-hmm. These kind of protests have been going on since about 2016. In fact, one of the largest protests happened. People from across the country, with their hard-fought money, came to Delhi to make the government listen, but unfortunately they haven't listened. We just have one demand. The president should not sign this bill. They should send it back to parliament using their powers under the constitution, and this bill should be completely rejected.
So the community feels that the bill, I mean the transgender bill 2019, tries to reduce the community to mere bodies rather than recognizing their rights. So thank you, Ray. Thank you, Shum, for joining with us. Thank you. You